Hello and welcome to PDFSupply.com. Today we're going to be testing a BBA-106 Genius block. I have part number here IC660 BBA-106. This is a 6 input analog block, measures current source. So in order to test this, we're going to test all the functions and features of the device. The first thing, of course, is the handheld monitor and the port that it connects to, make sure that that's working. The serial port that is connected to our bus controller. And that is a Genius bus controller IC693BEM331. And we have that attached to an IC693CHS397 5-slot rack. It's being powered by an IC693PWR330 power supply. And it's being controlled by an IC693CPU374 processor. Of course, I'm using Prophecy Machine Edition software. So the first thing I want to do when I check this block is to go into the handheld monitor. The part number is IC660HHM501. And I want to configure the block to match the information that I have in the Prophecy Machine Edition software. So I'm going to click OK, F4, F3 configuration, F1 program block ID. I've already programmed this to be block number 1 just for simple sake, but the way I did that was I pressed F2, changed the block number 1, and enter. Okay. And now since the information is the same as it is in the Prophecy Machine Edition, and that I have the processor in run mode, I have an I/O enabled light. So if I shut the processor off, the light goes off and it goes back on when it's in run mode. This is telling me that the Genius block is talking to the Genius bus controller, which is configured through the software through this serial port. So I know that that's working. And I also know that the monitor port is working because I'm able to configure it. Next thing I want to show you is to go back to home, F3 for configuration, F2 to configure the block. And for my purpose of testing, I have the Genius block set to all the factory standard settings that it comes with. You may have different settings, and I don't recommend that you change those settings. Just showing you what I do when I do a test. So the first thing is I do want to report faults if there are any. And next, channel active, I'm going to select yes for all 6 inputs. I want to test all of them. Then after that is the scaling. I'm just going to show you one, F2 to show the scaling. My scaling is factory standard, but what I've done is I've made sure that all the settings are the same for each channel. Therefore, I'm going to be looking for the same response from every channel to make sure that they're all working and that there's not one or more channels that have a very different result, and then that would tell me that it could be bad. So I've got that. Another thing I want to show you really quick is that the configuration protection I have disabled just for the purpose so that I can make changes if I need to during my test, but for your purpose you may want to keep it enabled to protect what you have. So I'm going to go back to home. F2 to analyze the block, F1 to monitor the channels, input 1, input 2. It only shows 2 inputs at a time. And what I'm using to generate the milliamp is a 4 to 20 milliamp generator that I have these probes, these leads, so that I can touch them to the corresponding channels and check what the result is using the handheld monitor. So for input 1, and I'm going to explain what I'm doing in the background, is I'm touching the leads from the generator to input number 1. Those are on terminals 11 and 12. Okay, and I'm getting a result of almost 20,000. Input number 2 is 15 and 16, terminals 15 and 16. Again, result is almost exactly the same. Hit F1 to toggle over to inputs 3 and 4. and I'm getting the same result for 3, touching terminals 18 and 19. On channel number 4, I'm touching 22 and 23, terminals 22 and 23. I'm going to hit F1 one more time to get us over to channels 5 and 6. We're going to touch the two leads. To the corresponding terminals in just a second here. Terminals 26 and 27 give us the same reading as that we've seen with the previous 4 channels. And last is terminals 30 and 31 for number 6. Again, same result. So now that I've seen that every channel has pretty much the exact same result, I know that this is a good working block. I know everything's communicating properly. So if you power up your Genius Block and you don't get any lights at all, or if you try to use the handheld monitor and you try to store information the way I showed you by programming the block ID and all you get is question marks, which means that it's not able to store the configuration, or any of the inputs have what you would consider a false reading or an inaccurate reading, these are all very common problems with Genius Blocks. And that's something that we do repair here. We offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured products, and same-day shipping. So if that is something that you need or interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.